Krishna. My dear devotees, before we set up, or as we set up, I just would like to introduce this particular kirtan. Thank you very much. Lately I have been thinking very much about the question, when does Krishna hear our prayers? You know, we sit here in the temple room in Goloka Dham and we chant from morning till evening, or as much as possible. The question is, when does Krishna hear our prayers? You might say, well, he always hears, no? He hears everything. He's in every atom and between. But it's not that easy. He really listens to the prayers of someone who approaches him in surrender. In the Bhagavatam, I believe two or three chapters are dedicated to telling the story of Gajendra. He had been a great devotee, but he had been cursed to take on the body of a more or less dumb elephant. And when he was attacked by a dangerous crocodile, he somehow remembered deep inside that, oh, now only the Lord can help me. And he spoke these beautiful prayers, and the Lord immediately appeared. So this tells us something. We are also in one way forgetful of Krishna. We are very busy with our lives and the various relationships in our lives, relationships to the world, to our jobs, our various urgent and not so urgent responsibilities. And they cover us so that we are a little bit in the situation, or the same situation of Gajendra, who just lived his life as an elephant with his friends and relatives, etc. Only when there is some danger in our lives, at the moment of death, the conditioned soul wakes up and understands, wow, these things don't bring me any permanent shelter or happiness or protection, and he then turns to the Lord with the mood of surrender. But in bhakti, we don't want to wait so long. We don't want to wait for the next accident. We don't want to wait for the next misery. Or we don't want to wait until death finally comes and then wake up and remember. No, we want to do this immediately in kirtan. And I liked very much what Narahari shared with us yesterday. He said, for him, kirtan means choice. He can choose to turn to Krishna, or he can choose to be absent-minded and be a little bit in his own little world of forgetfulness. To make the conscious choice, each mantra, I will address Krishna. That is surrender, really. There's this Kevalastakam, this wonderful prayer which says, it should be sung again and again. It should be uttered or spoken again and again. It should be heard again and again, the holy name, Harinama Eva Kevalam, is in truth everything. So when a devotee surrenders like this, to the chanting, but he really makes the choice. It's free choice. It's no one can actually make this choice for you. The best kirtan leader in the world, which you heard a moment ago, cannot make you turn to this. Your spiritual master cannot turn, force you or bring you to turn to Krishna. No institution, religious institution, can bring a soul to turn to Krishna. The choice, the sacred choice to turn to Krishna consciously is really your own choice. And it can be exercised, it can be practiced when you chant, where each mantra anew is a chance for you to attend to Krishna, to give him your attention. So we will sing now again. Sandhya Arati. Dear Lord, says Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you are everything to me. I say goodbye to the world of I and mine. Everything what is mine is you.
Krishna, Krishna. Rama, Rama, Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.